Hello, KTA Tigers. I hope you had a wonderful weekend. Today is Monday, November 7th, 2022. It's going to be a great day at KTA. We, like every Monday, have a mindful Monday for you to start your week off in a peaceful, ready to learn place. So here is Miss Wolf with today's Mindful Monday.
Good morning, KTA. Happy Monday. Today for our Mindful Monday, we're going to do just a moment of sensing the world around us. Sometimes when we're feeling a little overwhelmed, we just need to slow it down. We need to take a minute and just look at our senses, or feel our senses, and see and hear and be aware of the world around us. It can ground us. It can connect us back to the world that we're in. So for just a minute, I want you to take a minute. I want you to breathe, and I want you to just look at what you can see in the camera and listen to the sounds that you can hear. Okay? Okay, so what I love the most about this little exercise is that you can do it anywhere, whether you're sitting in your classroom or you're sitting outside. It gives you a minute to just sit. So what did you hear? Did you hear the cars going by? Did you hear me breathing off camera? Did you hear the rustle of the leaves in the trees? What about what you saw? Did you see the trees? Did you see the man running down the street? Did you see the cars moving? Those are all of the things that you get a chance to use your senses and ground yourself back to where you are so that you can work on being ready to learn and ready for the next thing that's coming up. So I hope that you have a fantastic week, and always remember, if you just need to take a minute, use your senses, use your hearing, your ears, your eyes, and take that minute to ground yourself and be ready for the next learning opportunity. Have a great week, and I'll see you next Monday. Bye-bye.
Yay. Thank you so much for that, Miss Wolf. I love starting our Mondays like that with just some moment of peace to be able to be ready to learn and to have an awesome week. Well, I have another video to share with you. This is from my friend Santiago Ariza. As you know, he is running for student council president. He has continued to give me ads, and I had told all of our candidates, if you have any ads to give me, really tomorrow's last day. Tomorrow is voting for student council. So please give me your ads today if you have anything else that you would like to share. I really was impressed with Santiago putting this together, and I'm not going to say anything about it, but it's got lots and lots of surprises that I am sure many middle school, elementary even, staff are going to be very excited to see along with some students. So here it is. Thank you. Thank you so much for that, Santiago. I wish you and everybody else running for student council elections tomorrow good luck. And that was so much fun to be able to look back on some of our KTA alumni that are now Corona del Sol Aztecs. All right, friends. My student assistants and I would like to remind everybody that this Friday we will not be in school. The reason for that is because we are honoring veterans for Veterans Day. So November 11th is always Veterans Day. If November 11th falls on a weekend, then we observe the day on a different day. So Friday the 10th, we are off school because November 11th Saturday is Veterans Day. So my student assistants right now are currently working with veterans hospice care, veterans who are in care at this time, but would love to have a message, a picture, a letter, a drawing, anything you would like to send any of the veterans. They would love to see your work and your notes and your messages. So we are currently in student assist collecting any of those things that you would like to send on to them, and we will send it off to our veteran friends by the end of the week this week. So I would like to ask that anything you have is ready by Wednesday. We will be stopping by lunches. I may have coloring pages. I may have little letters or notes or things where students can write a quick thank you for your service or thank you for serving our country, whatever you would like to say to veterans to tell them have a happy Veterans Day and to honor them on that day. So teachers and classrooms, if you have any special projects you want to send off, please get them to me. And other than that, we will try to collect some things during student lunches this week. So I will see you there. I wanted to give a big shout out to my student assistants. They have also been working on this as a special project. And this is Lyle and Michael. They are two amazing student assistants. And what you can see them doing there is working with a first grader. They have been visiting all of our kindergarten, first grade, and second grades every week and going through high frequency words on word cards and collecting data on how much the students have improved in kindergarten, first, and second grade. When a kindergartner, first grader, or second grader masters a list of words, we are going to start recognizing those students and with something special, some special surprise. And they also then move on to a harder, or more challenging word list. So great job to all of our K-1-2 students. And thank you so much, student assistants, for making that work and that extra practice with reading possible. I'm very proud of you. This is another great chair that I am so excited to have. So this is my friend Julian. He is a fifth grader in Ms. Rodden's class. And I think he had shared with us in the past his interest in karate and how he came to be interested in that and all of the hard work he has done in that sport. So I was so honored, so excited because Julian asked me to come watch him do karate. And it wasn't just any night. It was a super special night for Julian. His family was there. His grandparents were there. And they were all there because he was being honored by working up to his brown belt. So brown belt is about, from my understanding, Julian would have to correct me if I'm wrong, but I think it is two more steps away from then going on to black belt. So I was just so impressed, and I want to give a shout out to Julian for setting a goal, working towards that goal, and he is well on his way towards achieving that goal of wanting to become a black belt. But the other piece is for everybody to remember that type of achievement, that type of hard work has taken him many years. He started that before 2020, his mom told me it was when he started. So he's worked on that for two whole years. So if you have something that you would like to do, some goal you would like to accomplish, Julian is a great model. He's been working up in little tiny steps, getting better and better and better in lots of different skills to get himself to where he is right now. And one of the things I loved about going to his class and seeing it was on their t-shirts. You can't see it in the pictures, but it says something like the difference between a black belt, which is the final belt that's as high as you can go in karate, and a white belt was that a black belt never gave up. So there is really no difference. That person that got to a black belt just kept working all along the way while other people may have quit. So you should be very proud of yourself, Julian. I do have a video of you getting that brown belt. So this was like the little ceremony that they had at the end of class. Julian had to demonstrate all kinds of skills. His mom said that he had to show he got good grades. They talked to her about if he's showing good behavior at school and at home, if he's maintaining all of his responsibilities. So if he's all around doing everything he needs to do, not just in karate. And then they check his skills in karate. So this is where we clapped for him. And then his teacher ties his belt on him. And it was so cool. We were so proud of him. So Julian, congratulations again. And if anyone else has a special talent or interest out there, we always love to hear it. We always love to highlight it. And I would love to hear more about how you may have worked towards a goal like Julian did. All right, friends, a few reminders for this week and coming up in the month of November, our new month that we're in now. So tomorrow is Luminati's, I think I said that right, pizzeria night. So if you are interested, that is on Alma School, and you can go from 4 o'clock till 10 o'clock and help support our PTO, have some pizza and help support PTO. On November 16th, this is interesting and it's something we've never done before. So in partnership with the Elks, they are having a hoop shoot, so a basketball shoot off, and the categories are 8 to 9 year olds, 10 to 11 year olds, and 12 to 13 year olds. It is free. If you are interested, you do have to register. The link went out in the Tiger Times, but depending on how well you do in our KTA hoop shoot, you would then go on to compete in the Elks hoop shoot if you're interested in doing that. So very cool if you are a great basketball player and you want to show off your skills, or if you just do it for fun or maybe have never tried before but want to see if you're good at it. This is a good chance to be able to try it out. So I hope lots of people do that. I will definitely be there to watch you. So that will take place after school on that day, November 16th. We do have a school spirit day we have coming up in honor of Thanksgiving. So our very favorite, one of my favorite days of the year, so much fun. Wednesday, November 23rd is going to be our annual turkey trot. So it is a school spirit day. Come dressed and ready to run in the turkey trot. And there will be more details about turkey trot coming up as we move through the month of November. But know that on that day is when that event will be. And you're free to wear athletic gear, something that you would be comfortable to run in on that day. All right, friends, I think let's check. It is time for my moment of inspiration. This moment of inspiration is really special. This is from my friend Milan. About a week or two ago, she gave me a poem about a rainbow. I have big hopes that Milan will like grow up and become a poet laureate. She loves to write poetry, and I think she can do amazing things with that. So when you see my moment of inspiration today, it is accompanied by a poem. You'll hear my voice reading Milan's poem, and she was the one who drew the moment of inspiration. So that will be followed by our moment of silence, our KTA Tiger Pledge, and then our Pledge of Allegiance. And I hope you have a wonderful day. Go Tigers! I woke up in the morning. I took a walk to school. I saw a rainbow. It made me drool. It was so colorful. It was so cute. It was so colorful. It was not like my boot. I got to school. It disappeared. When I looked again, it was there. It rained again, and it was so cold. It rained again. There was a rainbow. Bye. Milan.